I had $50 in my pocket, a bag of clothes, my daughter who was 2 years old, I was pregnant with my son. I had to leave that abusive relationship to save our lives. It wasn't simple at all for me to leave, but I had faith.
When Melita arrived, she was scared. She had very limited funds, and she came here to find a safe place to live.
The people at Caring Unlimited, they opened their arms, they opened their doors. They didn't give me a handout. I had to work really hard. I had to create a plan, and I had to show that I was willing and capable and motivated to make a change and create a future for me and my children. I couldn't end up in another dangerous relationship.
What we do at Caring Unlimited is that we remind women of who they are. These women are very strong, they're smart, they're capable. They know how to make good choices for themselves and for their children. They've somehow lost that sense of themselves.
Now after 3 years, we're in our own apartment. My children are well, they're healthy, they're safe. I am a student, I am the president of Phi Theta Kappa, I am a soccer mom, and I enjoy speaking out against domestic violence.
In grammar school, they didn't really know what the problem was, but my mother wanted, she kept on going to the teachers saying there's a problem, put him in a special class or put him in a special school, and they said I didn't really need it. There's one situation that I put in for a job, for a promotion, and I got it, and this woman that I was working with said I didn't deserve it because I needed help.
Bruce always was shy in a social situation and hesitated to talk and meet people because he thought people would find out that he was dyslexic.
Me and a friend of mine went out to lunch, and the literacy program was in the same building, and he said, would you like to go to the literacy program and speak to him and see what you think? And I walked in there, and Anne and Colleen were so wonderful. They made me feel like I'm a person.
As his ability to read has increased, Bruce's sense of self-esteem, of self-worth, has also increased dramatically. And the man who used to be very shy is now a leader, is now an active participant at Literacy Volunteers.
I got out of my shyness, as you can see.
And now Bruce has organized a group to go to Washington, D.C. next March and advocate for the cause of literacy.
My self-esteem is growing so much that I'm proud of myself now. And it's the best thing that ever happened to me. We belong.
After a back injury at work, I had to have surgery. After the surgery, doctors had told me that I'd never be able to play with my kids again or teach my boys how to play football or anything. I'd be pretty much sitting on the sidelines and taking some type of narcotic for the rest of my life. One time, me and my family were at church, and I was so addicted to the drugs that I would go to the bathroom during service and take some of the narcotics. And one day, I looked up, and I seen myself in the mirror. And I didn't want to be that person. I didn't want to be that dad.
When you see someone like Jerry in an environment like the YMCA, and the reason I'm here is you see a changed life. You see somebody that saw something in the life that they wanted to change, and they went for it. And it's very fulfilling for me as a professional to be able to look at a life such as Jerry's and see that we make a difference.
It was just hard at first, but kept on thinking of my kids and my wife, kept on thinking of them. And then slowly but surely it got easier and easier and easier, and then I realized my back's not hurting no more.
Yeah. I think everybody at the YMCA is proud of Jerry and each person here because, again, we are a family. I think if you look at staff, if you look at members, non-members, we're a family. We're one large community, and we're here to encourage one another.
Doctor said I'd be having a hard time, you know, walking a couple miles, let alone anything else, and now I'm jogging 5 miles a day with my wife. The kids try to keep up, and they can't.
Underneath everything we are, underneath everything we do, we are all people, connected, interdependent, united.
When I couldn't turn back, I had someone to turn to. Thank you, United Way.
Lucy does change lives. It changed mine. Thank you, United Way.
For a while there, the good days were few and far between. But now every day is a good day. Thanks, United Way.
When we reach out a hand to one, we influence the condition of all. That's what it means to live united.